I'm here in London to meet Ashley Brown. She's a paper conservator, very highly recommended, top of her game. I've got something in here which is really delicate, very close to my heart. I love it. Hi, Ashley.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. Oh,
good to
what
meet
have you got
you
for me here?
It's very, very delicate,
oh,
which is why it's in this much stronger container.
Oh.
It's a poster.
Ah, oh, this is absolutely amazing.
Yeah, look at that.
Oh, that's fabulous.
Isn't it? Star Wars, the original film.
Star Wars.
1977.
Wow.
This Star Wars movie poster dates from 1977 and advertises the original film that began the trilogy that spawned a billion-dollar franchise and launched a pop culture phenomenon. It was printed in the United States for use outside the country and so has no American Motion Picture Association rating. Torn and distressed, it's obviously been in the wars, and Saxon is hoping the restoration force is strong with Ashley.
It's really structurally a bit in a worrying state. I'm worried enough about this large tear and these holes at the larger areas where the intersection of these folds are happening that I would suggest that this whole poster is lined, as in backed with Japanese paper to make sure that it gives it
that
some
makes
structural
complete sense,
some structural stability going forwards. But then also I think this discoloration can be washed out. This is a pretty hard poster to come by. I mean, how much was this?
500.
Really?
And it was like, take my money.
Yeah.
bearing in mind that the life of these things, they were meant to be put up when the thing was
exactly
in the cinema and that's and then bin, basically.
Yeah.
So the fact that it exists at all is amazing in itself.
Amazing. This was actually a really exciting meeting. I really wasn't expecting such an iconic piece of, you know, Star Wars memorabilia to come in. Structurally, on the other hand, it's very worrying. I'm really worried about that whole giant tear along the bottom crease, and I really want to make sure that when we line it, that it's stable enough to, you know, survive another 40 years. I will try my best to get it back to, you know, its original glory. And, hopefully very, very quickly we'll be in a much more presentable position.
Music to my ears. Right, I will see you on the other side.
Great.
Bye for now.
Bye. I'm going to continue spraying this with deionized water, and I'm going to put some dry blotters underneath so that the dry blotters can really soak all of that dirty water from the top down to the bottom, and it will just enable the cleaning process.
Meanwhile, to find out more about his stellar piece of cinema history, Saxon has travelled to Great Yarmouth.
I'm here today to meet Matt Fox. He's a Star Wars collector with a huge collection that's being showed in the museum here. He's got toys, memorabilia, the whole lot. He's been collecting for over 40 years.
Great Yarmouth's Time and Tide Museum has been hosting an exhibition of Matt's collection, with over 400 pieces of vintage memorabilia from the original Star Wars trilogy.
Well, Matt, this is an amazing exhibition. I'm transported back to being a five-year-old again. It's incredible.
I think you and I are the same age, Saxon, and, saw this film. It was the very first film I saw at the cinema back in 1977, and it was such an incredible experience to see Star Wars on the big screen.
So I've brought you a poster to look at today, well, a photo of a poster I'm having restored anyway. Condition isn't great.
Yeah.
What do you think?
This is fantastic. So this is the Style A poster, and this was painted by an artist called Tom Jung, the very first painted poster that was done for Star Wars, and he created this lovely sort of cross motif there, which is very strong, gives sort of a feeling of good and evil. And, you know, no more of these will ever be created, and conserving it for the future is a noble thing you're doing, sir, a noble thing.
So this poster is a British one or an American one, do you think?
This is actually an international poster. Here's an example of the British version of the poster.
Yeah.
This was sort of the repainted version that we had here in Great Britain, and this was done by the brothers Hildebrandt, but it's painted in a bit more sort of vivid, cartoony form. It's got a bit more of a fantasy feel to it.
So do you actually own one of these?
I do have the British version, but I don't have this international version of the Tom Jung, so I'm rather jealous of you, but I think with nice restoration, £1,300 in a specialist auction should easily be achievable. I think you've got a rather marvellous thing there.
Meeting someone like Matt is always really good because he can give me his forensic knowledge of this kind of thing, which in a collector's market does come down to very special attributes, such as the fact that it's an international poster, not a British poster. It's now just up to Ashley to get those creases out, get it backed onto the paper, and we'll get it sold.
So let's see what is happening underneath. Oh, wow, okay. So this is a great example. So much discoloration has been just totally drawn out.
While still wet, the poster is ready for the next stage, lining the reverse side with sheets of backing paper. A delicate yet cumbersome task, which takes four hands to achieve safely.
Lining is kind of a nice replacement to having to do a lot of tiny repairs to, you know, enable some structural stability to the poster. I really want to make sure that this is as straight as possible. So I've got a very, very large roll of Japanese paper. I'm going to use three sheets of it perpendicularly to the poster. So going against the poster, which is actually very good for the poster anyway, because it'll add a lot more stability in going against the grain. I have also this strange mixture, which is a solution of methyl cellulose and wheat starch paste, both of which are adhesives that are used quite often by conservators, because wheat starch paste is essentially glue that's made out of the same fibers as a lot of types of paper. Right, all nicely lined and very, very flat and totally pasted out.
Now comes the critical phase, quickly turning the backing paper and aligning it on the poster beneath.
Yeah, and we're gonna just come around. Now lift it nice and high.
This process is like pasting a very large, expensive, and fragile piece of wallpaper. It's fraught with risk, and a tear would be disastrous.
And now this side, again, just slowly like draping it, because we want to get as much connection as possible. Yes. Yes, 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 yes! Woohoo!
The poster will now need to slowly dry out before the finishing process can take place.
Now that it's lined, it will be so much more stable and easier to deal with. So, yeah, this is definitely an absolutely vital stage of treatment. Hi, Saxon.
Hi, Ashley. Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
I knew you were coming, so I've prepared a surface.
I think it's just about big enough.
It's about right.
Very different from how it came in.
Look at that.
But here we go.
Really good.
Oh, I'm so glad you think so.
Oh yeah, it's amazing. To now see this like this is very, very pleasing.
When Saxon found this 1977 cinema poster, it was a constellation of black holes, and the creased and torn paper was liver spotted with age. It's now light years ahead of that sorry state. 40 years of stains and grime have been leached away. The tears and gaps have been seamlessly filled and blended in, and the all-important galaxy is blazing with stars once more.
I mean, first impressions, I can see more stars.
Yes.
It's like going out into the countryside and looking up at the sky and you can see more stars. It still looks old, but it looks like it's not about to crumple into bits.
Yes.
And it looks brighter as well.
It's one solid piece, finally.
Yeah,
so
thank goodness.
That's good.
Yeah.
It was quite a struggle at times, but I'm really pleased with how it's turned out. I'm glad you really like it.
I've been worried about it while you had it, I must admit, because it's just such a special thing.
Yeah. Well, I'm glad I could do it justice, honestly.
You did, definitely.
I'm really glad that I got to work on something that was not only kind of fun and so, you know, near and dear to the hearts of lots of people, but also is a beautiful piece to work on, and yeah, it's a true artifact.
In terms of value now, I think it's a case of put a silly price on it, see what happens.
Yeah. Well, anyway, till next time.
Yeah, I'm going to stare at it for a bit longer.
Great.
I'll see you soon.
See you soon. Bye.
Bye. To have that original cinema poster from America that would have been staring out at people in 1977, I think that's pretty magical.